สวัสดีค่ะ So we are moving on to the second part of chapter 3. This is gonna be about solubility equilibrium. So the solubility equilibrium, according to the name of this equilibrium, it suggested that we are looking at the equilibrium in the solution. This particular solution about the dissolution of ionic compound. So we're gonna see the equilibrium between the solid and their ions. When we talk about solution, solution consists of solute dissolved in solvent. If we look at different stage of solution according to how much solute that can be added to the solvent. If we add some solute into the solvent, we zoom in this particular part. This is the solute. At this stage, we are looking at the unsaturated solution. This unsaturated solution, we have not the maximum amount of solute. So we can see that the solute can dissolve into the solution. Some of it may deposit back onto the solute itself, but more dissolve than deposit back. If we move on to the next stage, this is the saturated solution. Saturated solution occur when the rate of dissolution of solute into the solution equal to the rate of deposit back of the solute into the solid. So red arrow is equal to the black arrow here. If we somehow can dissolve a lot more of the solute into the solution, more than this amount, we make a supersaturated solution. Supersaturated solution. It has more solute than it should be. If we have this stage of solution, it's quite unstable. If we add some seed of crystal into this supersaturated solution, we will see the precipitate form down here, or zoom in here. The solute in the solution will deposit or precipitate back into the solid form. In this topic, we will focus on this saturated solution, where we have the maximum amount of solute in the solution. Of course, it's gonna have to be for a certain temperature. We learned from last semester about solution in that we can increase the solubility of some ionic compound by increase the temperature. So in this topic, remember that we're gonna look at this saturated solution where we see the equilibrium between the solid and their ions in the solution. So the definition of solubility equilibrium, I bring it up for you here again. This is the dynamic equilibrium that exists when chemical compound in the solid state is in chemical equilibrium with a solution of that compound. We will focus on the equilibrium of slightly soluble salts, the salts that only dissolve in water in very little amount. So the equilibrium between the solid state and the ions will be kind of lies to the left, the ion concentration in solution would be quite small. And if we look at any ionic compound, I made it up with this formula MAXB. This is metal, this is non-metal, or the cation part and the anion part. It can be the polyatomic ion. If we separate this ionic compound into ion in water, it's gonna be separate into cation and anion. When you make balance equation, we're gonna get MAXB separate into A mole of the M plus and B mole of X minus. This is quite important. So you have to be able to recognize the formula of ionic compound and be able to balance the charge and the atom in the balance equation. And this is the equilibrium. We learned from chapter 1 already that any reversible reaction, we can derive the equilibrium constant. And that equilibrium constant is equal to the concentration of product divided by concentration of reactant raised to the power of stoichiometry coefficient. Without the substance in pure liquid or solid form. Remember that? If you remember it, for this particular equilibrium here, we can derive the equilibrium constant K, and that will be concentration of product, which means the cation, the anion, raised to the power of stoichiometry coefficient. The reactant is in pure solid, so we do not include that in our K expression. This specific equilibrium, the equilibrium constant is the KSP. So the K, as I mentioned, the specific name for this solubility equilibrium, K, is called the solubility product, and we use KSP to represent it. The solubility product is a measure of the solubility of compound. So you can see from the expression that if we have high value of KSP, it means that the concentration of ion in solution are high, which means that compound give a lot of the cation and anion in solution, which means the compound is quite soluble in water. If the KSP is low, it means that the concentration of ion are also low, right? So the solubility of that compound is low. So on this slide, let's practice to write the balance equation for ionic compound and derive the KSP value as well. The first one, silver chloride, separate into ion as silver positive plus 1 and chloride negative minus 1. What is the KSP for this? KSP for this one would be concentration of silver ion times concentration of chloride ion raised to 1. We don't write it down. The next example, the magnesium fluoride separate into ion as magnesium 2 positive, magnesium ion, and fluoride ion. We have subscript 2 here, so we produce 2 more of fluoride ion. You must balance charge and number of atoms in the equation. So the Ksp for this magnesium fluoride would be concentration of magnesium ion raised to 1 and concentration of fluoride ion raised to 2. Some students on the previous year made a mistake like this. This is the concentration of ion, not 2F. Okay, concentration of fluoride ion only. Number 2 here is going to be the power of the concentration. Let's try the next example. How about the silver carbonate, which separate into this silver ion 2 mole and 1 mole of carbonate ion? What is the Ksp? And the next example, if you have calcium phosphate, what would be the balance equation and what would be the Ksp? Please pause and come back when you are done. So the Ksp for silver carbonate should be like this. Silver ion concentration raised to 2 multiplied by carbonate ion concentration raised to 1. For the last one, calcium phosphate should separate into 3 mole of calcium ion and 2 mole of phosphate ion. And the Ksp would be concentration of calcium ion raised to 3 and concentration of phosphate ion raised to 2. This is the knowledge that you learned from last semester. You have to be able to write formula for any ionic compound, and you must know the charge of the cation, the charge of the anion, and you can balance equation. From this equation, you should be able to derive the Ksp. These are the example of the Ksp value for different ionic compound. This is the solubility equilibrium, and this is the Ksp. You can see from this slide that the Ksp are quite small value raised to negative number. So the solute that are listed here are the slightly soluble compound, and it shows by the very low value of the Ksp. So again, the Ksp value indicates the solubility of ionic compound. In general, the smaller the value of Ksp, the less soluble the compound in water. But it has a note here. When we use Ksp values to compare the solubility, we should compare compounds that have similar formulas only. For example, the ratio of cation to anion must be the same. Like this one, silver chloride, 1 mole cation, 1 mole anion. You can compare Ksp to the zinc sulfide, 1 mole cation, 1 mole anion. If you want to compare solubility of calcium fluoride, you shouldn't compare it to silver chloride because the mole ratio of cation to anion are different. But you can compare it to the iron to hydroxide here, which has the mole ratio of cation to anion the same. I put the note in the document, nakha, so look up from there. So move on to the calculation part. How do we get the Ksp value? This is the solubility equilibrium of this ionic compound. The solid is in equilibrium with their ions, cation and anion, and we derive Ksp is equal to concentration of cation raised by A times concentration of anion raised by B. To get the value of Ksp, we must know concentration of cation and concentration of anion. And this concentration of the ion relates to the value that is called the molar solubility of the solid. What is the molar solubility of the solid? If we assume this particular one to be x molar, x can be any number. If the solid has the molar solubility equal to x, it means that in the equilibrium, it's gonna have concentration of ions like this. If molar solubility of the solid is x, in this particular one, it will produce AX molar of cation, and it will make BX molar of the anion. And the Ksp would be equal to AX raised to A times BX raised to B. So this amount will be put in here. This amount will be put in here as well. So on this slide again, it's very important that you know how to derive this solubility equilibrium of the ionic compound. Now, let's have a look at what is the molar solubility, or how do we get this value. Okay, นะคะ. This is an example. When we look at solubility of solid, in this particular one, I put the example of sodium chloride in water. Solubility of solid is how much solute in saturated solution, how much solute in saturated solution. So in this example, if we add 40 grams of sodium chloride in 100 milliliter of water, this is what we get for a saturated solution of sodium chloride. We have 36 grams of sodium chloride in 100 milliliter of water, because we found that there is 4 grams of sodium chloride remains undissolved. In saturated solution, it contains 36 grams of sodium chloride in 100 milliliter of water. From this example, when we talk about solubility, we can see solubility in two forms. One is in the form of solubility, let's look at the solute in mass or in terms of weight in gram per solution in liter, or we can look at solubility in the form of molar solubility, which look at solute in mole per solution in liter as well. So in this example, what do we get in terms of solubility and molar solubility? From example here, for a saturated solution of sodium chloride, the solubility is equal to 36 grams per 100 milliliter of water. 36 come from here, 36 grams sodium chloride in 100 milliliter of water. So this is the solubility. We need to change milliliter here into liter. So we do it like this, multiply by this conversion factor. 1000 milliliter is equal to 1 liter. So the solubility would be 360 gram per 1 liter. How about in terms of molar solubility? We change mass into mole. Like this. Molar solubility of saturated solution of sodium chloride would be 360 gram per liter multiplied by this conversion factor, change grams into mole. This 58.5 gram is the molecular weight of sodium chloride. So we get the molar solubility of sodium chloride here is 6.15 mole per liter. So we're gonna take this value. This is the molar solubility of ionic compound. Use this value to get the Ksp. So if we look at the equilibrium of sodium chloride and its ion, sodium chloride is in equilibrium with sodium ion and chloride ion. Ksp is equal to concentration of sodium ion multiplied by concentration of chloride ion. If the molar solubility of sodium chloride is 6.15 molar, this means the sodium ion in solution would be 6.15 molar. Chloride ion concentration would be 6.15 molar because stoichiometry coefficient here 1 and 1. So molar solubility give the same amount of ions. Put this in here, we're gonna get the Ksp value. So for sodium chloride, the Ksp is 37.8. If you look back, compare this value to the Ksp of the slightly soluble salt, we see that for sodium chloride, the Ksp is quite high, which means that we learned from the solubility rule already that sodium chloride is actually very soluble in water. That shows by its Ksp that the value is quite high. I only bring it up to show you about how to get the molar solubility. So now you know how to get the value of Ksp from the solubility or molar solubility of ionic compound. And the question that involves the Ksp and the solubility can be seen in these two types. The first one, you are given equilibrium concentration, which is the solubility value, and you are asked to find the K, equilibrium constant. In this topic, it means the Ksp value. Or you are given the K. In this topic, you are given the Ksp. You are asked to find equilibrium concentration. In this topic, it means solubility value. I put this diagram to show you the steps to calculate the Ksp. From left to right, you have to know solubility of compound, or at least you have to know molar solubility of compound. This is in gram per liter. This is in mole per liter. If you are given the solubility in gram per liter, you have to convert it into molar solubility. If you know the molar solubility, then you can find out the concentration of the ions, the cations and the anions. If you know concentration of ions, put that into the Ksp expression and calculate the Ksp value. Okay, this slide show you the example. If you have a question like this, you have solubility of barium sulfate, BaSO4, is 0.00246 gram per 100 gram of water at 25 degrees Celsius. Calculate the Ksp of this barium sulfate. This barium sulfate is very insoluble in water. In 100 gram of water, you only have this amount of barium sulfate, very little amount. Okay, calculate the Ksp. What is the step? What do you know here? You know solubility. So you know solubility of compound. That is 0.00246 gram per 100 gram of water. The definition of solubility is in fact grams of solute per 1 liter of solution, right? So you need to change this 100 gram of water into 1 liter. Do that by this conversion factor, which is the density of water. Every 1 milliliter of water weighs 1 gram, and then change milliliter into liter with this conversion factor. You can cancel the unit like this. So the final unit you get is gram per liter. Alright? Now, we need to move on to the next step. What is the molar solubility of this compound? We get the solubility as 0.00246 gram per liter. This is from the first step. Now we change gram into mole with this conversion factor. 1 mole of barium sulfate weight 233.38 gram. This is molecular weight of barium sulfate. And this is your molar solubility. Next, what do you have to do? You need to find concentration of ions. You need to find concentration of ion. Barium sulfate is in equilibrium with barium ion and sulfate ion. When you know molar solubility, this is the calculator. Type in this ratio, okay? Okay, this is the answer here. Sorry, didn't mention about that before. Anyway, this is the molar solubility. This is one. Which means that concentration of ion must be the same value here. Okay. Molar solubility of compound give concentration of ions. And then put this concentration of ions into our Ksp. So calculate the Ksp. This is the Ksp expression. Concentration of barium ion times concentration of sulfate ion. This is quite easy. Put in the number and do the calculation. This is the final answer. This is your Ksp of barium sulfate. So you see that you have to follow the step so you get to the final answer. Let's try another example. A saturated aqueous solution of silver carbonate contains 32 mg of silver carbonate per liter of solution at 20 degrees Celsius. What is the solubility product constant or the Ksp of this silver carbonate at 20 degrees Celsius? Same thing, right? You are given 32 milligram of solid per liter of solution. This is the solubility value. So solubility value is 32 milligram per liter. You need to change milligrams into grams. Do this with the conversion factor. Now, get the molar solubility, then get the concentration of ions, then put the concentration of ion into the KSP. Pause นะคะ and try to do that yourself. Can you do it? Remember to write the correct solubility equilibrium for silver carbonate. Here are the answer ค่ะ. Solubility of compound. Remember to change it into gram per liter. Then calculate molar solubility. Change into mole by conversion factor of molecular weight. 275.8 is the molecular weight of silver carbonate. You get this molar solubility. Concentration of ion. Write the equilibrium. Silver carbonate is in equilibrium with silver ion and carbonate ion. Don't forget to balance this with 2. You have molar solubility of silver carbonate equal to 1.2 times 10 minus 4 molar. This will give 2 of silver ion, which means this amount นะคะ 2 multiply by molar solubility. And carbonate has number 1 here, so you put molar solubility amount here. Then put this number into the KSP. Put this number into the KSP. This is your concentration of silver ion. The KSP is equal to concentration of silver ion raised to 2 multiplied by concentration of carbonate ion raised to 1. This is the value and do that by the calculator. And you get the answer 6.9 times 10 raised to minus 12. This is your KSP value. Practice to type in the calculator as you write on the paper. You shouldn't get the wrong answer and use the calculator correctly. Mm-hmm. This is times 10 to the power of whatever. This is a good thing to do. Okay? Okay. Previous example, you given solubility value and you calculate the KSP. The next example, you are given the KSP value, then you are asked to find the solubility. This is the question. From the solubility equilibrium and solubility product constant of silver sulfate as shown here. This is the solubility equilibrium and this is the KSP value. The question asks you to calculate the molar solubility of silver sulfate. You learned previously that this is the step to calculate KSP. Now you are given the KSP and you are asked to calculate molar solubility of compound. Can you go backward in the reverse direction? The answer is no, because the value of KSP will not give you the concentration of ions and it will not give you the molar solubility of compound. So the question mark here, how do we go by and find out about it? The only thing that you can do about this is by assume the molar solubility of the compound to be X molar. Once you assume this to be X molar, So you derive concentration of ions according to the solubility equilibrium. This is gonna be with the x as well. And you put the x thing into the KSP and you solve for x. You will get the answer. So let's see how do we go by with this question. Assume the molar solubility of the compound to be x molar, which means the concentration of ions according to this solubility equilibrium would be 2x for silver ion and x for sulfate ion. Put this into the KSP expression. This is your KSP. Silver ion concentration raised to 2 and sulfate ion raised to 1. Okay, now put down the KSP value and silver ion concentration, which is 2x raised to 2, concentration of sulfate ion, which is x. Do this calculation, rearrange it. 1.4 times 10 minus 5 would now equal to 4x cubed. So the molar solubility of silver sulfate or x can be calculated from the root here. Put this in the calculator, นะคะ. And that is the answer. This is the answer. Okay, x is equal to 0.015. This is the molar solubility of silver sulfate. So the calculation in this topic may involve this rest to strange and different route that you need to use calculator to solve for answer. So it's important that you know how to use your own calculator to find out the answer. Let's move on to the final part of this topic. Once we know about solubility equilibrium and the value of KSP, we can answer these two questions as well. The first question is the solid would be more or less soluble? This is the same question of asking, is the equilibrium shift to the left or shift to the right? And we use the Le Chatelier principle to predict the direction of the change. The second question, will precipitate occur when we have a combination of cation and anion in solution? Will precipitate of the solid occur? We're gonna answer this kind of question by compare the value of Q reaction quotient with the value of K equilibrium constant. Let's see about the first question. Is the solid more or less soluble? As I said, this is the same type of question. Will the equilibrium shift to right or left? This is the solubility equilibrium, solid in equilibrium with their ions. If equilibrium shift to the right, mean solid is more soluble. Shift to the right, make more ion, which means solid is more soluble. So in the opposite direction, if equilibrium shift to the left, make more solid. So it's gonna interpret as solid will be less soluble. This work in the same way that we learned in chapter 1. Use Le Chatelier principle. When do we need to answer this kind of question? we can get to answer this kind of question when we have a system of solubility of solid in common ions with common ion. For example, this is example of solubility equilibrium for magnesium fluoride with magnesium ion and fluoride ion. The calculation result in the pure water, in the pure water, the solubility of magnesium fluoride is 2.1 times 10 minus 3 molar. If the magnesium fluoride is dissolved in solution of sodium fluoride, the solubility will be lower, found out to be only 3.7 times 10 minus 6 molar. Why is this occur? Because in this sodium fluoride, we have fluoride ion. We have fluoride ion. It means that on this side of the equilibrium, on this side of the equilibrium, we have more of the product present. We have more of the product present. The equilibrium will shift to the left. Equilibrium will shift to the left, which means magnesium fluoride would be less soluble, and it shows by lower value of solubility. Another condition that we may see the shift of equilibrium is when we have solubility equilibrium in different value of acidity of solution. For example, this equilibrium in acidic solution, this ion, which is the conjugate base of an acid, the base can react to acid, produce the weak acid and water. When this occur, this amount of ion in the equilibrium will be less, decrease. The equilibrium will shift to the right, which means that solubility of this compound will be increased in acidic solution. The second question, will precipitate occur? We need to compare the value of Q and K. Same thing to chapter 1. The difference is that now the Q is called QIP, ion product. Same pattern, QIP has the same pattern as the KSP. Concentration of cation, concentration of anion. The concentration here is at any point that is not at equilibrium. So we see from chapter 1 that if your Q is less than K, equilibrium will move in the forward direction. If the Q is more than K, equilibrium will move in the reverse direction. Like this, if QIP is less than KSP, equilibrium will shift to the right. When equilibrium shifts to the right, it produces ion. It produces ion in solution. Interpret as no precipitate will occur. No precipitate. In the opposite direction, if QIP is higher than the KSP, equilibrium will shift to the left. Equilibrium shift to the left mean precipitate will occur. Precipitate here is the solid form of substance will be produced. Okay, let's see the example that used the knowledge of QIP compared to the KSP value. Suppose we add lead to nitrate and sodium chloride to water to give a solution that consists of this amount of lead 2 ion and this amount of chloride ion. The question is, will lead 2 chloride precipitate? This is the question. Will lead 2 chloride precipitate? Given that the Ksp of lead 2 chloride is 1.6 times 10 minus 5. So you have to look at the solubility equilibrium of this lead 2 chloride, which is shown here. Lead 2 chloride in equilibrium with lead 2 ion and chloride ion. In this kind of question, you need to compare the value of QIP with the value of Ksp. Right now, we know that in the solution, we have cation 0.05 molar. We have the concentration of anion 0.1 molar. So we can find out the value of QIP like this. And this is the value of QIP. Compare this value to the Ksp value. We see that the QIP is higher than the Ksp. QIP is higher than the Ksp, which means that the equilibrium must shift to the left. Equilibrium must shift to the left. And the final answer is lead 2 chloride will precipitate. So in summary of this topic, we learn about solubility equilibrium. For any ionic compound, we can write solubility equilibrium like this. Solid in equilibrium with their ions. From the equilibrium, we can derive the equilibrium constant. This time it is called solubility product, or Ksp. And that equal to concentration of cation times concentration of anion, of course, raised to the stoichiometry coefficient. The value of Ksp indicates the solubility of solid. The lower the value, the less soluble of that compound in water. If you are asked about the precipitation when you mix cation and anion. If precipitation occur or will precipitate occur, you need to compare the QIP to the Ksp. And if QIP is more than Ksp, the precipitate will occur because equilibrium shifts to the left. Okay, this is very much based on the knowledge in chapter 1. So if you are unsure why Q and K compare like this, why equilibrium shift left or right, you have to revise on the topic about Le Chatelier principle in chapter 1. And practice to calculate the Ksp using your own calculator. And I see you the next topic. สวัสดีค่ะ